and this one's simply called Dad's Not a Football Fan. Dad's not a football fan, but I am. So in the pub, he asks a local man if he can buy his match programme for the quid he paid at the game. In savage rain, after his drink, he waits for string to be hacked from the bundles of the evening pink, and a Twix or a packet of minstrels for a sugar kick. Dad's not a football fan, but I am, so he fills the car with petrol, while Mum prepares a bag of ham sandwiches, crisps and the Beano, that ensures that the radio is tuned in for pre-match conversation between nervous commentators, post-match reaction, and even the results service later. Dad's not a football fan, but I am, so we scour for stadiums, legions of yellow cones outside midweek's floodlit radiance. Local kids offer to watch the car, but he knows it's cheaper to pay than walk away from sombre districts, where lockpicking is a characteristic which appears on Wikipedia's pages. Dad's not a football fan, but I am, so he sits in his hands and stamps his frozen feet while I sit next to him on a plastic seat wearing his gloves, cardigan and woolen hat. And I can feel his heartbeat entreating this 90 minutes to finish so he can feel blood rush once more beneath his blue jellyfish skin. Dad's not a football fan, but I am, but now it's not about me, it's about him. Time for his pastimes, interests and cowboy films. Dad's an antiques fan, but I'm not. So we travel to a special time where the price of things are valued by the impression they make in our lives. They meet somewhere in the middle of a stall selling football albums, sugary teas and disposable cups from the burger vans, and a love for this time together.